Let's talk about penile girth augmentation with the material. I think it may be the mostly known material in cosmetic surgery, silicone. In breast augmentation, this is standard procedure because liquid silicone is a clear, oily liquid with very favorable properties. It looks and feels natural, which is desirable for a superior cosmetic outcome. But that's breast enlargement. The difference to penile enlargement is that silicone for breast enlargement comes in sealed cushions, which are implanted as a hole, so the body doesn't come into contact with the silicone itself. I remember watching Botched on TV, and Dr. Nassif and Dr. Dubrow put breast implants to the test. They threw them against walls and even ran over them with their sports car. Still, the implants didn't leak. Liquid silicone for penile girth augmentation isn't used in a cushion. It is injected directly into the penis between Buck's fascia and the dartos fascia. Please keep in mind that this is medical grade silicone, not the stuff you would buy in a hardware store to seal the joints in the sink. I mention this because occasionally there are horror stories about people attempting do-it-yourself cosmetic surgery using this type of silicone. So, what is my opinion? It works, and the effects in girth enhancement are comparable to the ones with the fillers I already introduced you to. But I have to say, in my personal opinion, I would not go for it if I were you. I think there are better and much less risky fillers on the market. What are the problems? By the way, did you know that you can become a member of UroChannel? I just started memberships. Check out the perks and become a member today to support my work. Your membership helps to maintain the high quality of my content. Many hours of preparation go into each of my videos to bring you the most up-to-date scientific knowledge possible. Silicone is a substance the body reacts to. These reactions can be quite severe with horrendous complications. When you inject liquid silicone, the body wants to get rid of it, so it sends its army of soldiers, which are called macrophages, to destroy the intruder. But that doesn't do the trick. The macrophages can't destroy the silicone, so the body switches over to plan B. If you can't destroy it, you'll have to isolate it. This is what we call granuloma formation. Connective tissue is wrapped around the silicone, basically. With time, hard nodules can be felt within the implant. Eventually, fibrosis will be seen. This is when connective tissue takes over. This may have an effect upon the cosmetic result. The penis may become thinner and also start to become uneven and hard. Silicone has a tendency to migrate to other sites where you don't want it to be. Even here, it can cause fibrosis. Years after the injection, funky autoimmune responses of the body may be observed. All of this is very unpleasant stuff, and on top of this, there is potential for erectile dysfunction and loss of penile sensitivity. Silicone is a permanent filler. Once injected, it will be a surgical mess to get it out in case of complications. However, it's not all bad. It has been proposed that if you use a high-quality product, injected in small amounts and multiple sessions with good technique, then the outcome may be excellent. This is liquid silicone. There are also silicone implants on the market. I think most of these are a bit freestyle concerning official approval. However, there is one popular implant in the US that has been approved by the FDA, the PENILE. This is what I'm going to talk about in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Ich weiß, dass meine Videos auch viele Menschen in Deutschland erreichen. Anfangs war UroChannel zweisprachig, aber nach einer Weile erwies sich das als nachteilig. Daher habe ich deutsche Videos vor ein paar Jahren ausgelagert. Sie befinden sich nun auf meinem Kanal Urologie.